Pete's a crier. Pete's an absolute crier.
Yeah.
Also, he drops his voice even lower when he's done something wrong. So, like, on Towie, whenever he cheated, because he did that a lot.
Whereas you go higher when you cheat.
No, I'm so sorry, I didn't mean to do that. Tiff, I'm sorry.
I'm Sam Thompson.
Have you had your haircut?
I have, yeah, yes.
Awful. I'm Pete Wicks.
We're here to play Who's Most Likely 2, the sequel to Who's Most Likely 1.
Go on then, open the box.
Yeah, right, sweet.
It's really bad. Who cut that?
I can't. No, don't say that. It's actually a really good guy.
Is it?
Yeah.
What, was he having an off day?
No, shut up. Right, ready? Who's most likely to ignore the other person's text?
That's me.
Kate, obviously, yeah.
100%.
He ignores half the text.
I don't often reply to you because you are so infuriating and pointless.
Do you know what he's got?
He's pointless.
This really annoys me. So he's that guy who's got, it doesn't blue tick, it's permanent grey ticks. You don't know if he's actually seen it or not. It's such an anti-social thing to have on your phone.
It's because you messaged me the most pointless crap. You're actually the reason I did that no blue tick thing, is because in the morning it was about 4 missed calls and messages. Do I wear a pink or blue t-shirt today? I don't give a monkey's what you wear.
I'll sometimes message P and be like, I can't get to sleep.
Yeah, they're the worst ones. And this is at about 7:30 in the evening.
Who's most likely to show up late to an event?
Pete, showed up late today.
No, I wasn't. I was here at 10:30 when I was supposed to be
here. Oh, wait.
Yeah, 100%. I was bang on time. You turn up late to everything.
Do I?
Yeah, well, I mean, you don't get invited to a lot.
Yeah.
But the things that you do get invited to, you turn up late to.
So no, do you remember that time we were meant to go for dinner and Pete turned up 45 minutes late and I was stood by the bar and it was Pete's gaff as well, it was like the place that he goes.
It wasn't my house, I didn't invite him for dinner at my house.
And the person knows Pete and he goes, are you waiting here for Mr. Wicks? And I was like, I am, do you know where he is? And he was like, no, and then you're 45 minutes late.
I was busy.
You know when like someone stood you up on a date, it was like, would you like another drink, sir? I'm like, this is embarrassing.
Oh, it's never happened. I mean, presumably before Zara, that happened quite a lot to you.
Let me pick.
Okay, go on.
Who's most likely to spend all their money on their pet? You.
Well,
you.
No, actually, no.
You.
I love my dog.
You've just bought Eric a new eye.
No, I haven't bought him a new eye. He's not a bionic dog. But if you go to Sam, so Sam and Zara have now got these ragdolls and the amount of gadgets and crap that they've got a fountain for their water. It's not just a bowl. I mean, they're cats, they don't give a monkey's what they drink out of. It's a fountain.
No, let me tell you why.
You've got
though.
A full cattery.
Yeah,
they actually bought, and this is the worst one, a remote control camera that goes on the floor so that they can follow the cats around the house and talk to them in case, Muffin, don't do that or whatever. Well, I don't, you change the name of cats every week. Oh, this is Duck. Well, it's not, is it? No. What do you call it?
It's called Albus and Cedric. Bunny.
Bunny. That's yeah, it. Bunny. It's not a bunny, is it? It's a cat.
We've got a camera on wheels, and it goes around the house. And even if you're not in the house, you can speak through it, and you go, "Hello, Albus," and then it goes, and then you follow them around the gaff. But you did buy your dog a glass eye, so that's cool.
I've not bought a glass eye.
You did? He has two dogs and both of them only have one eye?
No, one of them has one eye and the other one's about to lose the other one. So currently...
Because he pissed him off?
No, I didn't piss him off. It's not my fault.
He's en route for a...
There's currently still three eyes between them.
Cyclops.
Right. Who's most likely to get asked for a selfie in public?
Hey. People absolutely love Pete, but they have to be of a certain age, so not the down one.
Only because they think I'm Joe Wicks.
mate, people, so if you're 45 and above, they love Pete. I mean, I'm not even joking. Nans are all, aren't they? Nans are all over you. They and if people younger than 45 come up to Pete and ask for a photo, it's because my nan loves you.
Yeah. Yeah, that's the worst one, is that, yeah, it's got to the point now where it is literally just, my Auntie Susan loves you.
And your one-eyed dogs. Okay, I won't.
Why are you picking on the dogs?
I'm sorry, enough. Who's most likely to believe in star signs? I do believe in star signs. I'm a Leo. I'm a rising Aries, I think, actually.
What does that even mean?
It means you've got a moon that's coming into your sun.
So what is your actual star sign, Leo?
Leo, yeah. What are you, when are you born? You're in, when are you born? No one even knows when his birthday is.
To be honest with you, I forgot.
I have to ask his agent when his birthday is, because he doesn't like to tell people, because he's getting that old that he doesn't want people to celebrate his birthday.
No, I just don't like birthdays.
No. So,
but whenever you talk about star signs, if you ever speak to someone about star signs and I tell them what mine is, it's always the work. They always go,
"Why are you a Scorpio?"
Yeah.
Oh, I knew it! You stingy... I'm not going to swear, but you are a stinger.
What does that even mean? Why does everyone say that?
Because Scorpios suck. No one wants to be a Scorpio.
But we're the best one.
No, that's... No. Like, no one's ever... Even Scorpios are like, we suck. Yeah, well, take that.
I think that's rude. Oh, this is definitely you. Who's most likely to slide into another celebrity's DMs and get ignored?
Well, you, I mean, you do that on the regs. I mean, to be honest with you, is there a new one this week?
Well, Maya Jammer, I slid into a DM, but she did actually reply eventually.
Oh, yeah, no, I've noticed she's actually followed you now.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, very happy with
3
that.
3 weeks of working together for her to do that.
And you actually slid into Maura Higgins' DM, not for a date, but slid into Maura Higgins to get her on the podcast. And she didn't reply to Pete, so that's good.
That was an embarrassing one because I actually know her. But when we were trying to get people on the podcast, you were sliding into DMs. You slid into Kim Kardashian's DMs a couple of years ago to try and get her to go on a date with me.
Just in case. It was actually Kylie Jenner. Kylie Jenner's
the same thing, isn't it?
No, it's not. Ken Kardashian's. Kylie Jenner's the daughter of Kris Jenner.
And
what Kim is. Kylie Jenner's just the younger sister.
Right, okay.
Who's most likely to end up on the front page?
All right, well, I know what you're going to say with
that.
Yeah,
exactly. Yeah,
you're going to say me.
Let me tell you a story. Right. So, Pete Wicks vomiting outside Amazonico restaurant by Green Park.
Not.
No, it's not. Pete Wicks caught vomiting outside nightclub.
That's the completely wrong story.
No, it's not.
Firstly, it wasn't even there.
All right,
it was the picture. Near there.
No, it wasn't. It was outside the W Hotel.
Yeah, which is near there.
Not really, no.
So, same kind of vibe.
Actually, I wasn't being sick. I was drunk. But I dropped a cigarette and tried to pick it up, so I was crouched over. I wasn't actually throwing up.
Imagine, Pete! Like, that is that's the lowest of the low. Photographed by a pap vomiting down some side alley, dropping a cigarette, going, "Oh, no."
All right, listen, it wasn't my finest hour. However, I've seen you do worse, and weirdly enough, you've just not been caught.
Wait, what about this one? Pete Wicks saunters into strip club with Deli Ali's ex. They're friends, they were never together, but like Pete Wicks seen marching into strip club.
That has happened a few times.
It has.
Who's most likely to get a tattoo they regret?
Both of us.
No, that's gonna be Sam. And I know you would think it would be me, but I'm covered in summer.
You've got me on you.
Yes, and you've got me on you, but that's not even the most embarrassing one that you've got.
What?
When you spat with Zara.
Oh, don't do that. That's so bum out.
You had trust no one tattooed on your knee. But then you got back with Zara and went, no, it means trust number one.
It's because I got the number one. Do you want to see it?
Oh, it's huge.
I know, it's enormous. It's enormous and it's got a number one there. Yeah. And I thought, and the tattoo guy was like, why don't you say trust with the number one? Like it's like really edgy, and I'm like, that'll be cool, full of bitterness and anger. And then, and then, literally, the moment I got it, I went, well, that was a mistake. And I still haven't got it covered up. But Pete does have a tattoo of me creeping over his boxers on his hip.
That is a bad one because I didn't really have much space left when we had our show before it got cancelled. it didn't last very long. We got each other tattooed. And Sam had a picture of me on his forearm, and then I had Sam, and I didn't really have much room. So now, if I go on holiday or take my clothes off, Sam just sort of peeps over my pants.
Also, I look like Michael McIntyre.
And it doesn't look like him. And then we actually had them done. The tattoo artist had drawn pictures of us both. Sam changed his and asked for it to be more old, wrinkled, and a little bit more. I think you actually said, can you make his face more lived in?
Yeah. So as you can see here, I asked for two lines either side of the nose because I wanted it to be a little bit more representative of what Pete's actually like, because you look too good. Who's the most likely to cry on reality TV?
Well, that's a tough one because we've both done that.
Yeah. I'd say you.
Yeah. Probably is, yeah. I'm an emotional Pete.
Pete's a crier. Pete's an absolute crier.
Yeah.
Also, he drops his voice even lower when he's done something wrong. So, like, on Towie, whenever he cheated, because he did that a lot.
Whereas you go higher when you cheat.
No, I'm so sorry, I didn't mean to do that. I'm sorry, I did. Tiff, I'm sorry.
So it's weird because I go lower and you go higher. Yeah.
Hey, this is also years ago, by the way.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Before Zara.
I'm so sorry.
But we've learned a lot now. You know, We're older and wiser. But back then, Pete used to like, whenever Megan used to get annoyed at him, he'd literally turn around and be like, I just didn't know what I was doing. Like, people just sort of like, it just happened. And then I didn't expect like things to happen like the way
Whereas Sam would be like, Tiff, I'm so sorry, I accidentally fell inside her.
Who's most likely to embarrass themselves in front of another celebrity?
Pete. Geezer. Come on now.
Mate, you thought you were hosting the BAFTAs red carpet and everyone thought you were a waiter and was asking you to get them beers from the fridge. And you did it because you were too embarrassed to say that you're not the waiter.
Have you remembered that word for word?
You asked Ant and Dec if they wanted some cheese in 35 degree heat and they just walked away and said nothing.
Yeah, it's very true actually. I can't even remember
I've seen you in front of people. So thanks for watching Who's Most Likely To with Pete Wicks and Im.
Staying Relevant is a podcast for all ears and you can catch us on any platform you get your podcasts on. And remember to like, comment, and review.
Subscribe.
And subscribe.
Yeah.